Hello everyone, myself P.S. Patil. I am welcome you in our third lecture.
In the previous lecture, we discussed the inductive effect, and in the today's lecture, we will see the resonance effect. So we start with this resonance effect. Resonance effect, it is also called as a mesomeric effect. Another name for this resonance effect is mesomeric effect. For the explanation of this resonance effect, we consider the example benzene. It is very familiar to us, benzene. The scientist Kekulé was proposed the structure of benzene. The scientist name is Kekulé, proposed the structure of benzene. In the benzene, there are 6 carbon atoms and it contains 3 carbon-carbon single bond and 3 carbon-carbon double bond. So, Kekulé proposed the two structures of benzene. This one is the second, this one is the first structure proposed by the scientist Kekulé. What is the difference between these two structures? The carbon-carbon double bond, it is present at 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6 carbon, while in this case, it is present at 2 and 3, 4 and 5 and 6 and 1 carbon atom. So, according to the Kekulé, in this two structure, there are 3 carbon-carbon single bond and 3 carbon-carbon double bonds are present. That means, in this two structure, it shows the two types of bond length. So, the first carbon-carbon single bond length, it is 1.54 angstrom, while carbon-carbon double bond length, it is 1.34 angstrom. That means the Kekulé suggested these two structures, they show two types of bond length. One is carbon-carbon single bond, that is 1.54, and carbon-carbon double bond, that is 1.34 angstrom. But according to the X-ray crystallographic measurement, the benzene, it shows the only one type of bond length, that is 1.39 angstrom. The benzene shows only one type of bond length, that is 1.39 angstrom. That means it indicates it shows only one type of bond length. Means all the carbon-carbon bond length in the benzenes are equal. Okay. So, this is the most accurate structure of benzene. In this structure, all the pi electrons are delocalized in the 6 carbon atom. While in this two structure, the pi electrons are localized in the 6 carbon atom. Here, they are localized, while in the third structure, they are delocalized in the 6 carbon atom. Hence, it is a more accurate form of benzene. Okay, this structure, it is called as a hybrid structure. What is it called? It is called the hybrid structure of benzene. It is a most accurate form of benzene. It is called hybrid structure, and this phenomenon, it is termed as a resonance. What is resonance? The complete delocalization of pi electron in the molecule, that is nothing but the resonance effect. It is explained by using this benzene. Okay, it is clear what is resonance effect. Then we see the types of resonance effect. Types of resonance effect. There are two types of resonance. First one is electron donating resonance effect. It is termed as plus R effect. And the second one is electron withdrawing resonance effect. In the previous lecture, we see the inductive effect. In that, the types of inductive effects are also same. Electron donating inductive effect and electron withdrawing inductive effect. Here also, the types of resonance effect, in that the first one is electron donating resonance effect and the second one is electron withdrawing resonance effect, and it is denoted by minus R. Okay. So, we see the example. then the idea get clear. Here we consider the example phenol. We consider the example phenol. This is a benzene ring. Okay, so this oxygen, it is a electron rich species, so it donate this electron to the benzene ring. That's why here the electron density increases on the benzene ring. Hence this shows the plus R effect, that is electron donating resonance effect. Okay, here also we consider the example aniline. This nitrogen, it having a lone pair, that means it is electron rich. So this rich species donate electron to the benzene ring, hence it is also the example of the plus R effect. Okay, in the second case, electron donating resonance effect, we consider the example nitrobenzene. We consider the example nitrobenzene. The structure of nitrobenzene is this. This nitrogen is having positive charge. It is electron deficient. So it removes the electron from benzene ring. That's why here the electron density get decreases. Hence it is the example of a electron withdrawing resonance effect. Another example, we consider the cyanide group attached to the benzene ring. So it is also the electron withdrawing group. So it removes the electron from the benzene ring. Hence it is the example of a minus R effect. Okay, it is clear. So there are two types of resonance effect: electron donating resonance effect and second one is electron withdrawing resonance effect. Okay, then we see how to write the resonating structure. It is very important in the exam. Question is, write down the resonating structure of organic compounds. Different organic compounds are given and we have to write down the resonating structure of that compounds. Okay, so for that we consider the first, that is 2-butenol. We draw the structure of this 2-butenol. Null means what? Null, it is the functional group for aldehyde. 2-butenol. This Al indicate the presence of aldehyde group and this E indicate the presence of double bond. This double bond, it is present at the second carbon atom, hence it is the 2-butenol. Okay, it is very familiar to you, the nomenclature, how to write down the nomenclature. You have already studied this part in 11th and 12th standard, so I am not going to take again. So we directly see how to write the resonating structure. Resonating structures are always written by this two headed arrow because they are interconvertible. So we write by taking this two headed arrow. Then what happened here? This electron shift to this side. So we write CH3, CH double bond, CH, C, H, O minus. So here there is a formation of a positive charge. By removing electron, here the formation of a positive charge. Okay. Then in the second case, what happened? These electrons are shifted to this side. So CH3, CH, CH, double bond, C, O minus, H. And by shifting this electron, here there is a formation of a positive charge. Okay. Then this is the resonating structure of this 2-butenol. For that we write the hybrid structure. Hybrid structure, it is nothing but in the benzene we write the last hybrid structure. Same way here we write the hybrid structure of the 2-butenol. That means electrons are delocalized in this 3 carbon atom. So this is the hybrid structure of 2-butenol. So there is a delta minus charge and delta plus charge. So this is a hybrid structure of 2-butenol. it is 2-butanol. Okay, it is clear, it is very simple. So we write the resonating structure of 2-butanol. Then we see the second example, that is phenoxide ion. Phenoxide ion, it is formed by removing one hydrogen from the phenol. This is phenol. By removing that hydrogen, we get the phenoxide ion. Okay, this is phenoxide ion. Why we write ion? Because here the negative charge is there. So we write phenoxide ion. Then we write the resonating structure of this phenoxide ion. Here the negative charge is there, so it shifts to this side. So we write the resonating structure. These structures are also called canonical structure. So the second canonical structure is double bond. This bond is shifted to this side. Why? When this electron shift to this side, here the valency of carbon is increases at this carbon. Valency of carbon is 4, but here there is an increase in valency. So what happened? This bond shifted to this side. So to maintain the valency, so this bond gets shifted. Okay. Then what happened? This is shifted to this side. This one is here. So we get the structure, negative charge at this side, double bond, here double bond, remaining bond same. This is this side. It is clear how the delocalization of electron takes place. This side double bond is there. This is shifted to here. So negative charge appear here, O minus, remaining bond as it is. So this is the last canonical structure, last resonating structure. It is nothing but this one. So in the first and the last structure, what is the difference is that the position of double bond is different. In this side, it is from right side. Here it is from left side. So this is called the resonating structure of the phenoxide ion. And last, we write the hybrid structure of this. So how to write the hybrid structure? Only we put this dot in this way. So this is the hybrid structure. In the hybrid structure, we put the negative charge. At which position the negative charge are appear? So we write here. So this position, negative charge. At this position, negative charge is obtained. And at this position, the negative charge is obtained. So this is nothing but the hybrid structure of phenoxide ion. Okay, so it is clear, it is very simple. This is the resonating structure of the phenoxide ion. In the same way, we also write the resonating structure of aniline. So you have to write down this in your notebook. It is similar to this one. Only difference is that here instead of this O, we put the NH2. The remaining forms are same. So you have to write down the resonating structure of aniline in your notebook. Okay. So we take the example. This phenoxide ion is the example of plus R effect. Right. So we take the another example, minus R effect. And we write the resonating structure of that compound. In the minus R effect, we take the example nitrobenzene. So here we also take the example nitrobenzene. Okay, this is the structure of nitrobenzene. So here nitrogen is positive charge, electron deficient. So it remove the electron. So we write by removing, what happened? You have to practice this part, then you can easily draw the structure. Here the positive charge as it is, and by removing electron, here there is a formation of plus charge, remaining bond as it is. Okay, in the second case, this bond, it is stabilized by shifting the electron. So here formation of double bond, double bond, double bond, N O minus plus and plus charge obtained at this side. Okay, in the next structure this bond is shifted to this side, so positive charge appear here, double bond appear here, remaining part same, O minus plus O minus. Okay, so this bond it is shifted to this side, this is shifted to this side, so we write here double bond, double bond, N So this first last structure and first structure, what is the difference? Only the position of double bond is different. These are the resonating structures of the nitrobenzene. So we write the hybrid structure. How to write the hybrid structure? It is very simple. Only put this. Okay. From this side we move the electrons, so here also from this side also we can move the electrons, so there is a delta negative charge, delta negative, here delta positive appear, delta positive, this position delta positive, this position delta positive, and last position that is here the delta positive is obtained. Okay, it is clear. This is the resonating structure of nitrobenzene. So this is about the resonance effect. The last point is how rules for writing the resonating structure. The first rule is that all the contributing structure must have the same relative arrangement of atom but differ in the arrangement of the electron. For that we consider the example benzene. They have the same relative arrangement of atom but they are differ in the arrangement of electron. Electrons are arranged in different way. And second point, they are represented by this two headed arrow, and these structures are also called canonical structure. Why these two headed arrows are used? Because they are interconvertible. So always used this double headed arrow for writing the resonating structure. Then the third point is the contributing structure must have the same number of paired and unpaired electron. That means suppose we write this structure and we write the So what happened here? Here the radical is shifted and this radical is shifted to this side. So this radical form a double bond and this double bond shift to this side. So here the formation of radical. That means the contributing structure must have the same number of paired and unpaired electron. Okay, this is the third condition for writing the resonance. And the resonance it is possible when all the atoms are in plane. In the benzene all atoms are in plane, hence they show the resonating structure. The condition is that the resonance is possible when all the atoms are in same plane. Okay, and the fifth condition, more the number of canonical structure more is the stability of the compound. Means in the previous case we see the example of nitrobenzene. The nitrobenzene it is shown the different form, and as the number of canonical form increases the stability of the molecule increases. Okay, so these are the five points used to write down the resonating structure. Okay, it is clear. So in the today's lecture we see the resonance effect. In the next lecture we see the application of this resonance and inductive effect. Okay, thank you.